kingdom. And when we step off our kingdom, we are not being used to the highest capacity that we can be used. We have a responsibility to crown. It means loving the messy, the broken, the shadowy, the dark sides of ourselves. Because that's where the self-love is really needed. That's where the medicine.
We compare our personal timelines to people's timelines on Facebook. And we compare our personal timelines to people, the news feed on Instagram. And we feel bad about it. The beauty standards set by social media are unrealistic. 8 out of 10 women encounter negative comments on social media that critique women. Rosie is a published author on the subject of self-acceptance and beauty. La Negra Bella campaign and has been a social worker for over 16 years. And finds herself educating others on.
She's probably going to come out with her first book. Welcome, everyone. Welcome. Okay, so let's get started.
Down because you are in water or because you even fall in the water. You drown because you don't rise up. You don't stand up. You know, I don't want my daughters to live this, to see me this way. And I didn't know what to do. I was a single mom. My identity was gone. I lost myself in a relationship that was also abusive. So we all have these messy moments. And that we can rise up, we change not only our lives, but as you can see, we can change our daughters. And the ripple effect is incredible because this is a legacy mission to do the same, to be inspired, not because we're special, not because I'm special, but because we all are. And we want that imperfect. We all have imperfect lives. We're all going to have moments in which we want to pull our hairs out. But there are also moments of beauty in every single
place like against us, and it's that you have to give all the time. If you love, you give, you give, you give, you give. But what they didn't teach us, say yes more to yourself and more no to the others. That's the only two things. And also know when enough is enough. Like
that, I encourage them to fail and to, you know, figure out things on their own, because that's how you find success, is by.
I want to jump on the couch like Tom Cruise.
Come
like, I'm so excited. I'm having a Tom Cruise moment. I just think it's very interesting what you guys.
I was teaching yoga this morning, and she came to me and said, "This is the most amazing yoga class I've ever taken." And I'm thinking, in your entire life?
We're already in a really small place. And we're in that place because we believe in scarcity. We believe there's not enough. And so I think it's really important to just fact, there is no perfect. And because there's no perfect, there can be no imperfect. Like, if it doesn't exist, there can't be an opposite. And so I just really sort of hold my.
Perfect, I'm going to check you out. Like, I'm not going to lie to you. But one thing that I'm doing right now on social media, especially now that it's a woman's, that you don't know and compliment her. In the supermarket, and this is what I'm doing in my YouTube channel, this is a message that it's going to upload today. Go, sing, and we think we gotta go hide in a cabin for 1 month and just work hard at it, and it's not that. It's just like small.
And I've been a social worker, a clinical social worker for 16 years, so I started off my career doing individual therapy, and I've done a lot of different things, and when I think about very mindful about people's feelings and other how what somebody might be going through. So I think that for me, automatically, when I meet someone, I always want to try to make.
I would want to move around the whole.
Really?
My name is Monique Frasto. My blog is Turds and Chaos. It is a plus-size fashion and lifestyle blog. Fashion blogger, you want to have your group of friends, but you just want to belong to that group of like, okay, I am a fashion blogger, I am a beauty blogger. It is related to nationality. This
is very true because the people that are watching that segment are going to think that that was your point of view.
Yes.
So that will take away from your credibility just to be...
Yes, as Laura was saying, I'm very, very shy, so it's a challenge. Every time they tell me, like, oh, you have this segment, I'm like, I don't sleep, like, the whole week.
Basic. You have to be basic and think that people don't know. And whenever you're writing an article, you're delivering an idea, just think that there's a media. I need to be the bitch of the group. So they take the whole season, I was delivering my comments, and of course, you're standing with the moderator, you say, well, that... The only comment was, I would never publish that picture in a magazine. So what's the message that you get? That I am a bruja. Real. And I cried for the whole season. And then for the second...
Really spot that a mile away. So if you're just yourself, I think people will warm up to you more. They'll be more sympathetic.
It's totally fine. It's not going to kill the relationship with a PR. Also, there are ways to work with things. For example,
Leanne O'Regan.
A lot of wonderful and exciting opportunities coming to Disney parks in the coming year. Some unforgettable new experiences that are going to be awakening across our destinations. So just for
Animal Kingdom, it's going to have waterfront views with both indoor and outdoor dining. The theme is going to be travel and adventure, and there's bold immersive artwork throughout the entire restaurant. They are there. They are experts. They can help you plan and answer your vacation. All right. Traveling back to California, we just opened tomorrow
live at the Hyperion Theater. The live show will immerse audiences in the emotional journey of Anna and Elsa with all the excitement of live theater. And we just announced last week we had the opening date for that.
And once you are able to align everything that you're doing with that, you're going to be, first of all, much happier. Second, you're going to be much more successful because anything that...
...opportunities for your life, for your future, and for those who surround you. Este 2016 es hora de avanzar, de prepararse y de tomar decisiones.
Porque más grandes que tu pereza, que tu voluntad más persistente que tus obstáculos, sacude la mano y ábrete a un año nuevo.
Vive el amor empezando por mí.
Sandra, si eres fan.
Y yo, ay, tengo un gallo. Y habla Celis del canal Celis Carla y Limoncitas Brothers.
Paola Celis del canal Celis Paolos, Fabilitas del Consultorio Express.
Bueno, y Carolina Ortiz del canal.
Colaborar juntas, porque juntas como latinas podemos alcanzar más. Que digamos, si yo quiero alcanzar algo por mí sola,
¿no? Para que el trabajo salga bien hecho, pero al final el resultado se multiplica, entonces vale la pena trabajar un poquito más duro para llegar más lejos.
De WhatsApp y que podamos de verdad tener una red de apoyo a las youtubers latinas, así como ustedes lo tienen para las bloggers como congresos esos, pues de...
Vayamos a grabar el video, mandar el correo con todo lo que tenemos que hacer, todo, todo, porque como platicamos por WhatsApp, entonces...
La pregunta que tú haces es siempre invitar a la audiencia a suscribirse al canal. Si tú tienes más vista de los suscriptores, no es tan normal. Quiere decir que los que te están viendo, ella dice que funciona, mi canal empezó a crecer. Entonces dije, esta escuelita se la voy a recomendar a todos los amigos que tengan, se la recomiendo.
I know that because I have
have been part of their parent panel from the beginning, and they have.
You're not going to be disappointed. But we wanted to thank you all so much for all of the 81 submissions. We were floored.
Believing in the power of storytellers, I just want to say thank you so much to Anna when we talked about this idea. I do storytelling in Phoenix, and it's just. About when everything looks like it's the wrong thing to do, but your gut knows that it's the right thing, you go for it, and Gabby, take it away.
Year 2001, I'm 23 years old, and I have just graduated from my master's degree in journalism. Unemployment hit 25%, and the opportunities and the prospects for a recent graduate. And you start to believe that this lack of results, the lack of interest that you have from the world is a reflection of your heart and your self-esteem. So that's where I was in the year 2001 until I got a phone call from my friend Maria.
And just nurturing of souls. And let's fast forward, you know, after dinner, he said, we have to talk. And just so you know, background, we've been having some hard times already. But he looked at me and he said, Denise, I can't do this anymore. All I know is I felt someone's presence over me. A little while after that, and I opened up my eyes, and it was, dude, I failed you, and as much as I tried, I failed you. And I said, maybe I'll just leave me out here. I need space. My son said, go ahead, Mom, it's okay, I'm with you. And so he literally opened up the blankets, put me in the bed, covered me. You don't want to let your kids see you sad or hurt or anything. You want them to know you're okay because I'm okay. And he saw me at my weakest point, to the bed. And that's when I know, just pouring all that love, pouring generously into your.
I know my hope. I know my self-pity, actually, for feeling like, oh my God, he's just an angel. I'm so special. He was like five years old, and I was waiting for this meeting. And I'm there waiting, and I heard something like, oh, I have to take them to the cafeteria. And I'm like, oh my God, God, don't let me hear this if they are talking about my children. They have to stay there with the people like them. So I look at her, that it was my kid's principal. And she said, these kids, the special needs ones. And I felt so bad that I wasn't so disappointed and extremely, extremely, you know, impotent to not to be able to start with someone asking you, what are your dreams for your children? So I remember myself saying, I want my child to go to the cafeteria. Because before that, in my mind, everyone was beautiful, amazing, and they all love my kids, and they will look at him, at them and feel like we are the ones overprotecting. We are the ones telling other people with our behavior they can do it. And we have to be the ones. You can tell she has a totally different personality. So it was a shy one. I still feel like he's.
What happens? You say, oh my gosh, that's so cool. Oh my God, now what do I do?